So now we're going to touch on some material we talked about during the lesson on the brain, which was lesson 3. This material may feel pretty dense, but you can always refer to the document we're giving you on the physiological side of the stress response. Stressful events can cause changes in our physiology. Most importantly, we see that the autonomic nervous system, endocrine system, and the brain all interact together to produce changes in our body systems as a result of stress. Remember that the autonomic nervous system has both the sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous systems. Sympathetic is responsible for arousing, and parasympathetic is responsible for calming. Remember, for example, when Susan encountered the bear in Yosemite? This resulted in activation of her sympathetic nervous system, which allowed for an increase in heart rate, which pumped more blood to the large muscle groups, and more oxygen was available so her muscles can function and react to the dangerous situation she found herself in. In addition to the autonomic nervous system, the endocrine system is important in our stress response because it consists of the major hormone-releasing glands that are active during our stress response. That's the pituitary gland and the adrenal glands.